Jeanette Andrabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we are going to determine the differential equation governing the charging of a capacitor fed by a constant voltage. Give the expression of the voltage across the capacitor during its charging. Verify the solution of the differential equation. Give the value of the voltage across the capacitor at the instants 0, tau, and 5 tau. Draw the tangent to the curve UC at time 0. Determine the expression of the charge current. Determine the differential equations that govern the variation of the charge Q and the current I.
Consider a charged capacitor of plates A and B. The charge of plate A is the QA, whereas the charge of plate B is the QB. Since QA is the charge of plate A, then QA is given by C times UAB, where C is the capacitance of the capacitor and UAB is the potential difference between A and B. Similarly, since QB is the charge of plate B, then QB is given by C times UBA. But we know that UBA is equal to minus UAB. Then we conclude that QB is equal to minus QA. If UAB is denoted by UC, then QA, which is equal to C times UAB, QA can be written as C times UC, or UC is equal to QA over C. Now, let's determine the expression of the current in terms of the charge of each plate and the time t. This expression depends on an arbitrary chosen positive sense. If the positive sense enters the capacitor through plate A as shown in figure 1, in this case, I is equal to plus dqa by dt, or the time derivative of the charge qa. And if the positive sense leaves the capacitor through plate A as shown in figure 2, in this case, I is equal to minus the time derivative of qa.
Let's determine the differential equation that governs the variation of the voltage UC across the capacitor. Take UAD as UG, which is equal to E, and take UMB as UC. The switch is closed at time 0. Let's apply Kirchhoff's voltage law. UAM plus UMB plus UBD is equal to UAD. UAM is equal to plus RI because the positive sense is from A to M through the resistor of resistance R. UMB is taken as UC. UBD is the voltage across a closed switch, which is equal to 0. UAD is equal to E. Now, we want the differential equation that governs the variation of UC. So we need to replace the current by an expression containing UC. Look at the circuit. The positive sense enters the capacitor through the plate of a charge Q. So I is equal to plus dQ by dT. You know that Q is equal to C UMB, which is equal to C UC. Now, we need to differentiate this expression with respect to time. C is constant, then this is going to be C DUC by DT. Let's replace I in the above equation by C DUC by DT. This is going to be RC DUC by DT plus UC is equal to E. Divide the equation by RC. This is going to be DUC by DT plus UC over RC is equal to E over RC. This is the first order differential equation that governs the variation of UC during the charging phase.
The solution of the obtained differential equation has the form of UC equal E into 1 minus exponential minus T over tau, where tau equal R times C is the time constant. It is the characteristic time of the series RC circuit. The physical meaning of tau will be studied later in this video. Now, to verify that UC is a solution of the obtained differential equation, we have two steps. The first step, we differentiate UC with respect to time. And the second step, we replace the expressions of UC and DUC by DT in the differential equation, and then we arrange to prove that the left side is equal to the right side of the differential equation. So let's expand the expression of UC. UC becomes E minus E exponential minus T over tau. Before differentiating UC with respect to time, let's take this remark where A and B are two constants. The derivative of A exponential B times T is equal to AB exponential B times T. Now let's differentiate UC with respect to time. E is constant, so the derivative of E with respect to time is equal to zero. Now let's differentiate minus E exponential minus T over tau. This term is similar to A exponential B times T, where minus E is equal to A minus 1 over tau is equal to B. So the derivative of this term is equal to AB exponential B times T. So it is equal to minus E into minus 1 over tau times exponential minus T over tau. This is going to be DUC by DT equal E over tau exponential minus T over tau. Now replace DUC by DT and UC in this differential equation. We get this equation where E over tau e to the power minus t over tau is equal to duc by dt. E minus e exponential minus t over tau is equal to uc. So expand this term, we get this equation, and replace tau by its expression r times c, we get this new equation. We observe that the first and the third term have equal magnitude but opposite signs, so these terms cancel each other. And then we have E over RC is equal to E over RC. Since the left side is equal to the right side, we can conclude that UC equal E into 1 minus exponential minus T over tau is a solution of the differential equation.
Let's determine the expressions of the voltage UC across the capacitor and its charge at the instants 0 tau and 5 tau. The expression of the voltage across the capacitor is given by E into 1 minus E to the power minus T over tau. Let's start with the time 0. Now we will replace T in the above expression by 0. This is going to be E into 1 minus E to the power minus 0 over tau, but e to the power 0 is equal to 1. This means that UC is equal to 0 and that charge Q is equal to CUC. If UC is equal to 0, then Q is equal to 0. Look at the graph. At time 0, the voltage across the capacitor is equal to 0. Let's move to the instant tau. So we will replace T in the above expression by tau. This is going to be E into 1 minus E to the power minus tau over tau. This is going to be E into 1 minus E to the power minus 1. This means that UC is equal to 0.63E. Look at the figure. At that time tau, the voltage across the capacitor is equal to 0.63E. E is the maximum voltage across the capacitor. Now, what about the charge? We know that Q is equal to CUC. So we will replace UC by 0.63E. Rearrange. This is going to be 0.63CE. Now, what is CE? You know that the maximum charge stored in the capacitor is given by QM is equal to C times the maximum value of the voltage across the capacitor. But the maximum value of the voltage across the capacitor is equal to E. So we will replace CE by QM. This is going to be Q is equal to 0.63 QM. We conclude that at time tau, the capacitor charges 63% out of the maximum charge, QM.
Focus, please. This is important.
Now, at time equal 5 tau, similarly, Replace T equal 5 tau in the expression of UC, then UC becomes E into 1 minus exponential minus 5 equal 0.99E, which is approximately equal to E. Q equals C times UC. Replace UC by 0.99E, and we have C times E is equal to QM. So time equal 5 tau, Q is equal to 0.99 QM, which is approximately equal to QM. Then we can conclude that at time equal 5 tau, the capacitor charges 99% out of the maximum charge QM. And practically, the capacitor is fully charged and the steady state is attained. Remark, the expressions of UC in terms of E at T equal tau and at T equal 5 tau have to be memorized by the students, unless otherwise they are asked to prove these expressions. Now, let's determine the expression of UC and Q when T tends to infinity. We know that E to the power minus infinity tends to zero. So as T tends to infinity, UC tends to E and Q tends to QM. So we can conclude that theoretically the capacitor is fully charged as T tends to infinity.
Now, we want to draw the tangent to the curve UC at time zero. We have UC is equal to capital E into 1 minus e to the power minus t over tau. We want to differentiate UC with respect to time. The derivative of UC with respect to time is already explained in a previous slide. It is given by E over tau times e to the power minus t over tau. Now, replace t by zero. This is going to be E over tau e to the power 0, which is equal to E over tau. Now, E over tau is equal to the slope of the tangent to the curve you see at time 0. Look at the graph. We draw the tangent at time 0. Now, we want to determine graphically the slope of the tangent. The slope of the tangent is equal to delta u over delta t. We will choose two points on the graph. So we take the point 0, 0 and the point t, 1, e. So this is going to be e minus 0 over t, 1 minus 0. We get e over t, 1. Now compare the two red expressions. They are equal, which means that T1 is equal to tau. What can we conclude from this study? We conclude that the tangent to the curve you see at time zero meets the horizontal asymptote of equation UG equals E at a point of abscissa tau.
Let's determine the expression of the charge current. During charging, you see equal E minus E exponential minus T over tau. Since the positive sense enters the capacitor through the plate of a charge Q, then I equal plus dq by dt, and dq equals C times UC, so I equal C times dUC by dt. Now, let's differentiate UC with respect to time. E is constant, so the derivative of E with respect to time is equal to zero. Now, let's differentiate minus E exponential minus T over tau. The derivative of this term is proved in one of the previous slides. This term is similar to A exponential B times T, and the derivative of this term is equal to A times B exponential B times T. So it becomes minus E into minus 1 over tau exponential minus T over tau. This is going to be I equal CE over tau exponential minus T over tau. But tau can be replaced by R times C. Then I becomes CE over RC exponential minus T over tau. C cancels C, therefore the expression of the charge current becomes E over R exponential minus T over tau, and E over R is the maximum value IM of the current. We notice that during charging, the current decreases exponentially with time. Now, we have another method to determine the expression of the charge current. Using Kirchhoff's voltage law, E equal UR plus UC, or E equal RI plus UC. Rearrange, we get I equal E minus UC over R. replace UC by E minus E exponential minus D over tau, we get the final expression of the current, which is equal to E over R exponential minus D over tau, or I equal Im e to the power minus D over tau.
Let's determine the differential equation that governs the variation of Q. Apply Kirchhoff's voltage law. UAm plus UMb plus UBd is equal to UAd. Replace UAm by Ri and UBd by 0 because UBd is the voltage across the closed switch. Replace UAd by E. Now, we want the differential equation that governs the variation of Q, so we need to replace the variables of this equation, which are I and UMB, by expressions containing Q. Let's start with UMB. Q is equal to C UMB, then UMB is equal to Q over C, and I is equal to dQ by dt. This is going to be R dQ by dt plus Q over C is equal to E. Divide the equation by capital R. This is going to be dQ by dt plus Q over RC is equal to E over R. This is the differential equation that governs the variation of the charge. Let's move to the differential equation that governs the variation of the current. So we apply Kirchhoff's voltage law, and this is going to be Ri plus Q over C is equal to E. We want the differential equation that governs the variation of the current, but here we have Q. So let's differentiate this equation with respect to time. R is constant multiplied by the variable I. So the derivative of this term with respect to time is equal to R di by dt. Also, 1 over C is a constant multiplied by the variable Q. So the derivative of the expression Q over C is equal to 1 over C times dQ by dt. E is constant. The derivative of the constant is 0. This is going to be R di by dt plus 1 over C I is equal to 0. This is the differential equation that governs the variation of the current I.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.